Hello children, how are you all? Hope you are all watching our science videos regularly. Okay, so we have completed our lesson 1 yesterday. Can we have a recap of that lesson? Okay, let us go to our summary of the lesson. Okay, first point, all living organisms take food and utilize it to get energy for the growth of and maintenance of their body. Okay, did you understand children? Yes. Green plants can prepare its own food by the process of photosynthesis with the help of sunlight and carbon dioxide. Yes, everyone knows it. Yes, with the help of carbon dioxide and sunlight, it is preparing its own food in form of starch and sugar. Yes, okay. Green plants are called autotrophs because they can prepare its own food. So, they will come under autotrophic nutrition. So, green plants are called autotrophs. Chlorophyll and sunlight are essential for the photosynthesis. See, chlorophyll is a green pigment. So, only green leaves can prepare its food. Yes, am I right, children? Yes, what is the reason for the green color? Yes, that is a pigment called green pigment called chlorophyll is present in it. So, the green pigment and sunlight is very essential. Without the both, we cannot, plants cannot prepare the food. Okay. Carbohydrates can be in form of carbon, oxygen and hydrogen. So, the food prepared by the plant is in the form of carbohydrate. Okay. So, it is of three forms, carbon, oxygen, hydrogen. Okay. Carbohydrate is a product of photosynthesis. Yes. Whatever the food prepared by the plant, that is in form of carbohydrate. So, synthesizing carbohydrate is not enough for growth of plants. Children, can you tell me eating carbohydrate food alone is enough for you? No, it will give just energy. But what foods will make you grow? What foods will give you immunity? For that, you need to take proteins and vitamins, isn't it? Yes, likewise, plants also need to get proteins and fats. So, plants want to synthesize proteins and fats also. So, proteins are synthesized by nitrogenous forms. So, nearly, majorly, proteins are nitrogen components present in the air. So, next one. Yes. So, how they are getting those proteins? Yes. Can you remember, children? Yes, some bacteria present inside the root, what they'll do? They'll convert the gaseous nitrogen into usable form to the plant. By this, proteins are synthesized by the plant. Okay. Algae. Where you can see algae, children? Yes, near ponds, lakes, wherever the water stagnated, we can see algae there. Okay. Algae are the small green plants found in ponds, lakes and they are also called autotrophs. Yes, see, they are a single unicellular green small organism and it can prepare its own food. So, I told you, can you remember children? Because of algae only we are getting 87% of oxygen for the whole world. Can you remember? Yes, okay. Oxygen is produced in photosynthesis. Plants like cascuta are parasites that take nutrition from tree that is host. Yes. So, I told you an example. What is it? See, if you want to eat something, you need to ask your mom. Because your mom knows to cook it. So, your mom is a host and you are getting help and you are eating, getting from your mom. So, you are a parasite. So, likewise, cascuta is a parasite which takes nutrition on the tree. So, tree is called host. Okay. Saprotrophic nutrition is the nutrition that takes from dead decaying matter. Yes. So we have seen the autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Yes, autotrophic means it can prepare its own food. Heterotrophic means it depends on some other. So likewise, some organisms that take the nutrients from dead decaying matter. So those organisms are called saprophytes, and those mode of nutrition is called saprotrophic nutrition. For example, you can take fungi and mushroom. Did you see, have you ever seen children, mushrooms grow in a places where the most decayed matter found? Yes, yes. And also where you can see fungi is in your home? Yes, on the pickles and the breads and the rotten vegetables and fruits, on those surfaces we can see fungi. Yes, fungi derive nutrition from decayed matter. Some fungi are useful, like yeast and mushroom. Do you like to eat mushroom biryani? Yes, mushroom also one of the fungi. And yeast. Yeast is used to make cakes and breads. Okay. If you go and ask in bakery, they'll use this yeast. Okay. Some fungi are harmful. Some fungi can bring disease to humans. See, if the fungi get on humans, it will make some infections on the skin. See, those diseases are like ringworm, foot athlete, like that. Okay. And some fungi can be used to make medicines. Okay, so after this we have learnt about the replenishing of soil. So soil, due to the continuous cropping, soil gets less fertile, so it should be replenished by using manures and fertilizers. Okay.